Welcome to science session. Dear students, in previous class, in force and pressure chapter, we were discussing about the exploring forces, right? In today's class, we are going to study about effects of forces. Dear students, in my hand, one paper sheet is there. Okay, so in one paper sheet is there, I will apply force. Now, just observe what size of this. Okay, it is big sheet, right? It is one full sheet. So, by applying force, I will fold this paper. Okay, one more fold I will do. Now, what size it is compared to the before one? Before it was a big sheet. Now, when I apply the force and fold it, the size reduces. How this size reduces? How the size of this paper reduces to small one? When we apply the force. Means, what we can conclude? Force can change the shape, size of an object. Okay. Well, this is also one object. What is that? Force can change the size of an object. Okay, before it was a big sheet. When I apply the force, the size reduced, and now it is a smaller one, small in size compared to the before one. Okay, so what we can conclude that force can change the size of an object. It reduces its size when we apply the force. Some things can change in their size. Okay, this is first effect. Now, in my hand, the same paper this is there. What I do? I apply the force. How it was before? Before it was in a rectangular shape. Rectangular shape. When I apply the force, it comes to this shape. Right? So, what we can conclude? We can say that when we apply the force on some objects, the shape of that object may change. Right? What is the second one? What is that? Force can change the shape of an object. Right? Understood, students? So, here in my hand, one long chalk piece is there. When I will break this one. Okay. Before how it was? This is also chalk piece. This is also chalk piece, right? Before it was a long one, a big one. When I apply the force, two pieces are there in my hand. So, it is the change in the size of an object. Before it was a tangible. I changed its size by applying the force. Okay. So, what I will do again? I will do like this. See, a small, I will crush into smaller and very minute particles. Like this. Okay. The shape is changed. Completely changed. So, this is also an example for force can change the shape of an object. For example, where else you can observe? Your mama, when while doing the chapatis, a flour balls will be there. So she will do like this and she will press, make that flour powder into chapatis. Right? So that is also changing the shape of an object. Before it was in a powder shape. After preparing chapatis, it come to round shape of chapatis, means we can, by applying the force we can change the size of an object. We can change the shape of an object by applying force. One more is this. Okay, so third one is force can change observe one activity. Okay.
Here one ball is there. It is at rest position. When we apply some force on it, see, it is moving. It slows down its speed. So again I push it. So if it is already moving by applying force, I can stop this one. Okay. And one more thing. So it is just observed in which direction it is moving. See, it is moving by applying force. I just changed its direction. See, by applying force, I can change its direction also. And also, if it is already moving, by applying force, I can change its motion. Right? Have you observed? So, what we can conclude, by applying the force, can change its position or state of motion. Now it is at rest. By applying force, we can make it to move. If it is already moving, we can make it to stop, or we can increase its speed, we can decrease its speed, like this.
Okay. What you observe by this activity, we can conclude that force can change the state of an object, which means it is, if it is already in stationary position, by applying the force, we can make it move. Okay, if it is already moving, we can make it come to a rest position. And also one more, we observe that force can change the speed of an object. This one also you observe, right? If it is moving slowly, by applying the force, we can increase its speed. If it is moving speedy, so by applying this force, we can make it move slowly. Right? So, which means force can change the speed of an object. Okay? These are all the four effects of forces. I hope you are all understood of this topic. Thank you.